Today we're turning good metal into scrap with this Milwonky deep cut bandsaw.
I thought it was Milwaukee.
Yeah, you're right, Gary, it is Milwaukee. This is the Milwaukee CBS125 cordless bandsaw. But before, when we purchased this tool, we thought we'd best check out some other reviews. And yeah, someone out there had a little bit of a challenge with it, and hence, wonky metal was what came out of it. So we're going to try and do a better job with it today.
Or it might be the case of you can't cut it straight using a bit of kit, and you'll also see that as well. We've bought one of these, not for any other reason that we're actually going to use it and employ it here inside the studios when we have it rewired, when we pass it over to our tame electrician, aren't we, Gordon?
There is, yes. And obviously, yeah, what would you use it for? So it lives in the world of cable containment from what we're looking at from, okay, you could say it's a bit oversized for this, but we're looking at using some 4-inch trunking. And obviously, what other ways could you have to cut it? You could use chop saws. You could use, obviously, traditional hacksaw. But we thought, no, we don't want to. We'll try this instead of having tired arms or watching Eddie have tired arms.
Yeah, absolutely. And you're going to see at some point us cutting a series of lumps of metal that are in front of us. So hold on for that. But let's, first of all, let's take a closer look at the bit of kit that we've got in front of us, Gordon.
Yep. So this is the... This is the kit, yep. So it works on the M18 battery. So this is the first time we've featured a Milwaukee product on the channel. So if you're an expert in the M18 series, then bang a comment below. But it is what it is, a two-handed bandsaw, or we might call it a powered hacksaw. So again, we've got a trigger function here. If I pull the trigger, you'll see the blade starts moving. Two-handed, because obviously on the other side, there isn't a guard in place. On that side.
And is that a slow release trigger? So if you press that.
It is, yeah. So it's, I'll start. So you can start slow, but not too slow. So hold on, let's see. Yeah, then I can. Ah, right, yeah. And it has got in there, you'll see a little LED light.
Yeah, which can catch you out a couple of times.
Yeah, it does seem to help with the aiming, I'd suggest. And of course, you can increase and decrease the speed. So this is maximum speed. Wow.
Is there any other setting?
Well, we'll see. We're still getting used to it.
And slow.
And slow. Yeah, it's pretty simple tool, pretty simple to operate. However, first few attempts, yes. what I would say is if you can't cut to a straight line with a conventional hacksaw, if you use this, it's going to get a whole lot worse. When it goes wrong quickly. So I've got a few... first attempts here, Gary.
It looks like you've chewed that one off. Let's have a look.
Yeah, so...
Did you not bother to follow the line, no?
No.
Oh, you saved the best to last there. Oh, wow.
Yeah, so that was the first effort, and it did grab the lid and those things ricocheting across the room, one or two of that. So that was the first attempt we had at it. And, the channel, the channel wasn't much better. So we agree with our friend that we watched the video. If you're not careful, it is the Milwonky.
Yeah, it is. And we found that, didn't we, when we're bringing it, it isn't working necessarily like a chop saw. It wasn't a case of just bringing it straight down on it. We brought it in at almost 45 degrees in order to make more of a control and follow the line. You can't just go, I've got a bit of kit, drop it on, it's going to be square. So that's not the case.
So it is a bandsaw. So I guess the first thing, it comes out of the box, the blade isn't fitted. So best first thing we do before we get to our metal destruction, Gary, is have a look at how he got the blade on. So it's always a challenging moment, isn't it, when you have to put a blade in a new tool. So how did he get on, Gary?
Well, you wouldn't know because you didn't help me. So yeah, release the left-hand side there. We'll see in a minute what's happening. Move up the guide, flick it over, and then we can look at what we've got here. So this arm here is moving in and out of this section, which puts the tension in the blade. So you're obviously going to have it untensed when the new blade going in. Okay. Top tip for you, teeth go downwards.
All right, okay. Can you put it in the wrong way?
Well, I'm sure somebody would say you can. So it goes in these two little clips here, so push them firmly into position first. You notice how I've just pulled the top blade down, so you see it bulging out of the sides.
And I can see why you needed to get rid of that guide out of the way as well, otherwise you wouldn't get it in there, would you?
You wouldn't, no. So once I've got it, I've bulged it round, and now it's just really easy, just lay it into position. Obviously it's sharp, so be careful, make sure you wear the right gloves. Poke the blade into position, just check it's there. And then you're just going to add the tension back in by doing the lever on the other side. So you'll see the actual tension increase. Watch this. Pull it across.
Okay. Yeah. And there's only an on or off on that, is there?
Yes. Yeah. It's fully up or fully down.
Okay.
Okay. And then we just bring our blade guide down. So I think you'll all agree I made that look incredibly easy for my 18th attempt at putting the blade in. That wasn't my first attempt. There is a technique to it. There is a set of instructions, which I kept reading. But when you do get the technique, yeah, it did go in as easy as it did look. Okay. Yeah.
So you'll be revisiting that section of the video because I certainly had to live through the pain in the background as we went to...
And we couldn't use the original audio track either, did we?
No.
Again,
that little... you showed the guide plate there, Gary, that moves up and down.
Okay, let's have a look.
Yeah, but this isn't... It's not a safety guard or anything. This is just to help you guide it. So it is easily moving down. Now, we're still getting used to this in terms of the best position to do. So it helps you in some cases, in case of getting right up against the workpiece. But as I found on one of my attempts, it can get in the way when we look at it. We've got this sort of complex structure of a trunking here that, it sort of catches. So you've got to plan your angle of attack carefully when you're going in with the blade. And there is also one thing about it, there is a safety catch on there as well to stop you accidentally pressing the trigger. And you also can't lock it on, so you couldn't leave it running and walk off. Yeah, probably a good idea.
Yeah, that is a good idea. Well, I think we've teased it long enough. I think we ought to go over to the workbench where you cut many times, okay, some of this metal work.
Let's look at the bad examples. Let's have a recap of...
Do you want to go there again?
This is the first attempt.
Let's have a look at this.
Then we'll come back and look at the... so that was the first...
That lovely, didn't it?
So that didn't go well. And that was the... that was the channel as well.
Just rotate it over for us. Oh, yeah, look at that, yeah. Nice little slot.
Yeah. Not very straight.
Wow, I think we've waited about long enough now.
Yep.
Let's go over
with
and
some
let's
practice.
See you chop some metalwork.
To keep to the line.
So it didn't take us long to get to grips with the actual saw itself. We've only cut a few ends and already we've got the ability to get it a lot squarer than those early attempts that you had.
Yeah, I said earlier, if you can't cut straight with a normal saw, you're not going to be able to cut straight with that, because when it goes wrong, it does go wrong quickly. But again, it's not attacking it with a high speed. No. You don't, you know, it's not about a little bit of patience with it, going easy on the speed, especially when you come out of the workpiece as well.
Yeah.
Because that's when, if you're going at full speed when you're coming out and there's a lip, that's when it catches.
It is, yeah. And that's why we can't drop it down on it, because you catch both the lips at the same time. We found that didn't work, did we?
Yeah.
I love cutting the strut. Okay, that was, yeah. How much effort it goes in when you've got to cut those by hand. Obviously, if you're doing many of them, you don't want to cut it by hand. I'd probably choose this. Lightweight, isn't it? Easy to lift. Can be up the top of a scaffold tower.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, when we teased this out on social media before we actually did this review, and yeah, people are saying, oh, well, I'd just use a chop saw. Well, a chop saw struggles when you get to bigger pieces. Let's say this is the 125, so it'll do 125 millimeter square. A lot of our American friends use it on pipe, but we're probably more likely to be using it on trunking, and that's what we got it for. We're going to hand it over to our tame electrician, Eddie, when we do the rewire here. He also uses the Milwaukee circular saw for cutting metal, but again, circular saw struggles when you get to bigger pieces and especially some of those more complex shapes. However, I think it's probably the eFIXX viewers could help us out, Gary, couldn't they?
Yeah, we'd love your comments on this. Okay, you're going to tell me the number. What's the number of it?
It's the CBS125 with the M18 battery system.
Okay, we want your comments. Are you using this or something similar to this, and it's an incredible tool and you want to tell the community about it? Is there some top tips when using items like this, or is there something you think is considerably better and you've used both and you'd like us to review the other tool that you suggest? Leave those comments below, and if you can help anyone else out in those comments, we'd greatly appreciate it.